Hello everybody, I'm Direct Rex and welcome back to another episode of our Let's Build a Zoo series in Minecraft. In the last episode, we worked on a sloth enclosure. Now, the sloths don't go back up to the platform I built. They just stay on the ground for some reason. And yes, the baby sloth's neck is still broken, sadly. Hopefully it gets fixed. But in today's episode, we're going to be working on a capybara enclosure. Now, a lot of people suggested me to build this enclosure, so I'll put up their suggestions on the screen right now. Hopefully, I have put it up in a very cool way. But yeah, thanks a lot to these people for building, or not for building, but suggesting me the enclosure idea. I really, really appreciate it a lot. So thank you very much. And I saw a few comments here and there asking me or telling me that I don't tell the enclosure size. So I'm just gonna say it from now on in each video. Now this side over here, like the long sections of the sides, this is like a circle, a square thing. So I'll tell you the blocks length. Now this thing over here is 21 blocks, and all the sides where I have put this thing, it's 21. And these corners over here are 2, sorry, the corners over here are 3, 2, 2, 3. So that is how it goes. So there you go. Now you know the size of the enclosure. I don't know why you guys want to know the size of the enclosure, but if you are building this in your own zoo, I think that would make sense. So yeah, hopefully you guys got the measurement and it turns out well. And yeah, now as I'm building the zoo, I will just answer a question from a person called Connor Boy. But the reason I haven't built the path over here is because I want to add like a structure right over here, and for some reason I'm Steve, I didn't even check that. But yeah, that's the reason I haven't still built the paths. I'll make sure to build them, but I'm using a bunch of reference pictures to build this enclosure, so I think we can just start building it. And I'm going to be answering this question from Connor Boy, who asked if I could give any tips for content creators who are just starting out right now. Now, to be honest, I'm not a pro. I really don't know a lot about YouTube, and I feel like there's still a lot I want to learn, or I have to learn. But I could give some suggestions or tips that I have learned in my own experience while doing YouTube. And that is, I have 5 tips. Now these tips are not related to how to gain views, how to gain subscribers, you know, how to get 1 million views within a week or anything, because if you see my channel, I don't know how to do that. But these are just general advices that I feel like will help you, not only Connor Boy, to everyone who's starting out doing YouTube. And the first and most important thing is be yourself. There are millions of people on this platform, and they all, you know, a lot of them do Minecraft content, a lot of them do similar types of content, and the only way for you to stand out is to be yourself, because there's no one on this entire earth who's exactly like you, and your personality is like unique. So if you could be yourself and not try to copy others or imitate others, that will really, really help you a lot. And trust me, I have done this myself, and I do this time to time here and there, even in my recent videos, and I'm really guilty of doing it, and I really want to stop doing that. I want to be myself. So I think that's one of the best tips I could give you, is to be yourself, because if you be yourself and show your true personality and stuff like that, people are going to start watching you more, because you are unique. There is no one on this platform who is like you. So that is like that is like one of the most important things that I feel like people need to know, is to be yourself. And the next thing is, you don't need expensive stuff to start out for doing YouTube. I mean, if you can afford it, then fantastic, go for it. It will help you. It will definitely help you, you know, it will definitely give you a boost while doing YouTube. But if you really can't afford to buy expensive stuff, then don't worry. Don't worry at all. You don't need an expensive mic. You don't need all that. Just look at me. I use a microphone from my earphone and I use a free screen recorder that I got from Google Play Store. And for editing too, I just use a free basic video editor called VSDC. And so far, it's been working really, really well. I am not in need of a very expensive microphone or anything like that, although that can be very useful. But as of right now, for what I'm doing and for what stuff I have and for the resources I have, this is going really, really well. So, you know, you don't really need anything too expensive to start off your videos. You know, as long as it's watchable and your audio is decent, that's fantastic. You know, I recommend recording in a silent place, usually, if you can, because, you know, you really don't want to hear background noises. That is one thing I really try to avoid in my videos, but they usually somehow they end up coming in my videos. But you know, there's that. You don't need any expensive things. Just work with what you have right now. And if you're really serious about YouTube, as you go on, you can definitely upgrade and buy expensive stuff if you want. But if you're just starting out, I recommend just using stuff that you already have. I think just a normal earphone microphone and a free screen recorder will help you for quite some time, because you can just take me as an example. Once again, I don't really have anything expensive. The most expensive thing that I use to record my videos is just my device. Other than that, I have like a 400 rupees earphone and a free screen recorder. So if that is gonna work for someone like me, it will definitely help you as well. So there's that. The next thing is, don't focus on numbers. I have been doing YouTube for almost 6 years. Well, not 6 years. That's a total life. 5 years. I have been creating new channels. I've been trying to do that. I've been trying to do this. And what I have learned from my 5 years of doing YouTube and recently being successful is that just don't focus on numbers. Don't focus on numbers at all. I recommend, oh God, I forgot a slab over there. That's embarrassing. But I recommend just having fun. That's the most important thing in YouTube. As long as you're having fun, people who are gonna watch you are also gonna be having fun, because you know you're having fun, and if people are watching you having fun, they will of course also have fun, right? So I just don't focus on numbers. Like if you're not getting like hundreds of views or anything like that, that's very normal. Take it from a guy who has got like 2 views for like 5 years. So trust me, you just don't focus on numbers. Eventually, if you keep on trying and getting better, you will definitely just gain a following and an audience. And yeah, that is what I wanted to say. Like, numbers can really mess you up. Trust me, I have been like so demotivated by at times when people stopped watching my videos or I am not getting as much as views as I used to. Like it can be really, really demotivating, and I'm trying so hard not to focus on numbers, and this is like one of the most important things. So just don't try to focus on numbers. You know, of course having viewers and a following feels really good and motivating, but you won't get hundreds of people watching you within a day or anything like that, unless some miracle happens. But yeah, I recommend just not focusing on numbers. The next thing is, don't compare. Don't compare yourself to other YouTubers, you know. Just because they are gaining a bunch of views or if they have like a lot of subscribers and all that, don't compare them. Don't compare yourself to them, because they're doing what they have been doing that for a long time, and they know what they are doing. That's the reason they get all those views and subscribers. But if you're just a beginner, and if you have been doing YouTube for just a couple of months or even a year, just don't compare yourself to others, because that can really demotivate you and just throw you off. Instead of making YouTube videos, it will just demotivate you so much. So please don't compare yourself to others. you're unique in your own way, and that's the most important thing. Just remember that. Do not compare yourself to others. And the last thing is just don't give up. Just don't give up. If you are really serious about making YouTube a career, or if you're really serious about being a YouTuber and entertaining people, don't give up. Keep on trying your best, you know. Make a video today. If the video doesn't turn out good, try tomorrow. And if that video is better than the last video you did, that's fantastic. You improved. So, you know, just don't give up. Keep on trying your best. And trust me, you will eventually make it. It's weird how this is coming from me. I was almost about to give up on YouTube, but then I created this channel, and that's the reason. That's the whole reason. In the end of my videos, I say, do not just keep working hard and don't give up, because I have done that. I wouldn't say to a very far extent, but I've done that, and that has stuck to me. That has really stuck to me. Like, you just don't give up. Just seriously, just don't give up. Keep on working, and you will definitely reach it. Of course, all these tips are just coming from my past experiences, and you may disagree with some of my points, and these points may not work out for you as well, but just keep in mind that these are just tips coming from me and from my own experience, not like in general. So hopefully, Connor boy, these tips helped you a lot. And you know, for anyone who's starting out YouTube, that, you know, fantastic, dude. Like, seriously, fantastic. Like, that is really, really cool. I wish good luck to everyone who's starting out YouTube recently and doing YouTube, you know, just in general. If you started a brand new YouTube channel, good luck. And for anyone who's been doing YouTube, good luck to you as well. I just hope you all you know, succeed in YouTube. It's a very cool platform where you can just do what you like and have people, you know, watch you for doing what you like. I think that's a very cool opportunity that people have, you know. So yeah, good luck. But basically, what I've been doing this entire time while I was answering the question is that I have been adding some trees around the place over there. I've added this fallen log. Once again, I really like fallen logs, so I have added one over there. And also, I put this thing over here. I saw this in a picture from the internet, and they had these small, it wasn't exactly like this, it was an entire row of like water kept in a small like closed area. So that is what I tried to replicate over here, and I think I did a pretty decent job. Not the best, but I think I did a pretty good job. But yeah, I know this is like out of the topic, but I really hope those tips really helped you, because I feel like a lot of people just give up on YouTube, but if they don't see a lot of views coming in, like within a month or so, people just, I'm not saying everyone does it, but it's like, it's not that easy. Like, trust me, I have friends. I wouldn't call them friends, but I have people who I know who said, oh, I'll just upload a video and I'll get a bunch of views, dude. There's nothing really hard in that. And no, that's not true. You can't just upload a video and get a bunch of views and subscribers and become famous overnight. It's really not that easy. There are millions of people on this platform. So it won't be easy, but I think once you get a following and once you get people watching your videos, you really feel good. You really feel good. It's really motivating, and you know, it just brightens up your day. So yeah, once again, just good luck to everyone who's starting YouTube. I'm sorry if I sound very monotone in this video. I'm not sure what happened. My throat is kind of itchy. Oh God, this is not a good time to say that. But yeah, I'm sorry if I'm too monotone in the video. This is usually how I am. I don't like being too screamish when I'm recording videos, but yeah, I think this like small jungle-ish area turned out really, really well. So yeah, this is pretty cool. This is pretty cool. Very nice, very nice. Now, what else can we add? I was talking about adding a structure. Oh God, I totally forgot about it. Oh, dude, I really wanted to add a structure over there. Okay, fine, I think we'll add the structure over here. Now, I won't be showing me adding the entire structure because it will take some time, but I will definitely show you guys after I'm done building it. Now, I know capybaras like swimming around, so that's the reason I built this pond over here. I didn't really get a fun fact for today, but there is a fact that I know about capybaras. That is that these things are the biggest rodents in the world. To be honest, the capybaras look a lot more cuter than rats or anything related to them. They're pretty cute. I think capybaras are the most cutest. I think they're the most cutest looking rodents on this planet. I'm just gonna say it. To be honest, it's not like I know a lot of rodents. I know only rats, so there's that. But how is this place looking? I really don't want to like have like a huge jungle-ish area because most of the enclosures I saw, they didn't really have too much going on. They had like a small forest area, and they had a place for the capybaras to swim around, and they had a place for them to drink water. Now, I'm not sure if capybaras are going to drink water from here or from here. Anyway, they have choices, so there's that. And what I'm going to do right now is I'm going to add... I made a weird mouth movement, my God. But I'm going to add a small rock over here. So let's take the stone slab, and let's also take a andesite slab. And let's... Where is andesite? Where is... Okay, it's here it is. Alright, so I'm gonna add a stone, like the usual stone we do. Of course, you need to have a stone in the enclosure. If you don't have a pond, a fallen log, and a big stone, that is not an official Rectrex enclosure. No way in hell. But... I don't know why I said no way in hell. That I don't even know if that makes sense. But where should we add this? I feel like we could add just a small one right over here. I really don't want it to cover the entire enclosure up, so I'm just gonna make a small one. I think this much should be more than enough. I'm like really burning inside my room. This is horrible. I'm really looking forward to recording in winter. You know, I can kind of control the cold, but I really can't control the heat. It's really, really annoying. But there's that. But you know, how's your day been going? You know, have you been having fun watching this video? Like, what do you think? And that's it. I can't make this video more interesting. I'm not sure where I was going with it. But I'll place this right over there, and we will place some andesite slabs here as well. There we go. And oh, I totally forgot to place some here. So we'll just do this. There we go. And that should be more than enough. And as always, we will place some podzol and chorus dirt. Man, people made fun of me for spelling chorus dirt wrong in the Mythic SMP video. People in the sense of Ender. Thank you very much, Ender. Oh yeah, speaking about Ender. Ender made this awesome new fan art again, which looks really, really cool. So thanks a lot to Ender once again for this awesome drawing, dude. Like, seriously. My mood hasn't really been that good, and just seeing your drawings and stuff like that, it has been really, really helping a lot. So, you know, thanks a lot. I really, really appreciate it. And how does this look? Yes, it looks like an official Rectrex build. And we will place this here. There we go. Break the flower. We don't need flowers. Flowers are bad. We'll do that. And we'll do that. How does that look? Okay, that's very decent. It's not covering the entire stone. We'll go over here and we'll place that and probably one over here. Yeah, I think that should be more than enough. I think this is like more than enough for a capybara enclosure. Like, we could see everything, and I think there's enough space for them to run around. I think this is more than enough. I'm just gonna add I won't add like tall grasses, but I'm just add some patches of grass here and there just to spice things up. You know what I mean? Just to spice things up. So we'll add some here, and we will probably add one. I think that's more than enough. Let's try not to go overboard. But what I'm going to do right now is I'm gonna add like a bunch of bushes around the place. Bushes in the sense of adding leaves in a plus pattern. And also, I'm really not sure if I want to add that structure. Now that I think about it, I feel like, you know what? I won't add the structure. I'll probably keep it for something else. So what we're going to do is we'll just add the staff entrance. That's the best thing we can do. Where is the doors? Am I blind? Yeah, here are the doors. My God. So I'm just gonna plop. There we go. And we'll also just fill this up with stone bricks. Stone bricks have become my favorite block to use in this entire zoo. I've been using this block to like build enclosures for so long. I think that was about to come to me. But yeah, I like, okay, when I meant I want to build a structure over here, I meant I want to build like a wooden barn like structure, something that I built over here. I think it should be somewhere around here. Let me just show you. Where is the petting zoo? Here it is. I wanted to build something like this because I don't know, for some reason I thought that was a great idea, like where people could like get into the enclosure. But now that I think about it, I don't want to do that. It will look very messy, and it doesn't really suit the enclosure style I'm going for. Now, where is the enclosure? There it is. And by the way, yes, we will be working on the safari. Don't worry, I'm just not really motivated enough to work on the safari now. I really got burnt out pretty soon from the safari, which is kind of annoying, but that's fine. We'll just do this, and this. I told I'll do this off camera, but I'm just gonna do it on camera. It's fine. It doesn't really matter. I'll do that. I'll do this. I like how like the majority of this episode was just me answering the question from Connor Boy. But you know, it's good to do episodes, you know, similar like this. I enjoy answering questions. You know what? If you guys have any questions, feel free to ask me. I'll make sure to answer them in the videos. You know, that way you can get to know me better, and your answers will be, or your questions will be answered. There we go. I was about to say your answers will be answered, which doesn't make any sense. But we'll be finally adding the capybara enclosure. I am sweating and I'm very thirsty. I really just want to get some fresh air. But okay, we'll add a capybara here. Now, capybaras, I have a problem with these creatures in this add-on. They look really, really thin. Okay, like the capybaras look annoyingly thin. Yes, I'm gonna say it. Oh, that's a baby capybara. That's fantastic. But that's the only problem I have with these creatures, is that these things look so thin. Like, if you see them in real life, they're like really, really like round. And yeah, they're basically round. But these things just look like goats with capybara's heads on them. So I really hope, you know, if the add-on creator is watching this. Not sure what makes me think the add-on creator will be watching this video, but if he is, then please kindly change the capybara's model. It looks very thin. Of course, that's just my opinion. You don't really need to change. I don't think the add-on creator really needs to change it if he doesn't want to. But yeah, that's like the only problem I have with these creatures. But I think that's going to do it for this episode. I know it was kind of a weird episode for the normal people watching this video, but yeah, I really hope you guys enjoyed this video. Thanks again to all the people who suggested me to build the capybara enclosure. Hopefully you guys are satisfied with the way how I built the enclosure. But yeah, if you guys have any suggestions for the next episode, feel free to leave it in the comment section below. And also, I want to start building structures, okay? I want to start building hotels and all that cool stuff. So let me know if you would want to watch me building stuff on camera. If not, I'll build it off camera. That's totally fine with me. And also tell me what else can we build, because I don't really have any idea on what kind of structures or shops we can build. So if you could let me know, that would be really, really awesome. But yeah, thanks for watching the video. If you did enjoy the video, I would really appreciate if you could drop a like and subscribe if you want to join the Rekt Rex family. That's very cringy to say, but just subscribe if you would like to watch more. There you go. But yeah, I'll meet you guys in the next video, and until next time, keep working hard, never give up, and goodbye.